Habakkuk.
Amen.
You're gonna find it at the end of the Bible. So let's go to Habakkuk chapter 3. And we're gonna go to verse 2. Because I believe this is a prayer that we need to pray right now. That we need to be ready for what God is gonna do. So Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 2, the Bible says this. So we can read it together. So I'm gonna ask you to stand up, please. And I'm gonna ask the piano to help me, please. Bible says this, it says, O Lord, I have heard your speech, and I was afraid. And it says, O Lord, revive your work in the midst of the years, in the midst of these years, make it known, and wrath. Remember mercy. I want to read it one more time. Oh Lord, I have heard your speech and I was afraid. Oh Lord, revive your work in the midst of the years. In the midst of the years, make it known. In wrath, remember mercy. Amen and amen. And Father, we are here like Habakkuk today. Because every time we hear your voice, fear comes to my heart, but not fear that they're gonna be destroyed, but fear to do your will, God, and fear the Lord that the Bible speaks about. And Father, we are those that we can cry out like Habakkuk today. To say, Lord, revive your work. Revive your work in the midst of these years, God. And that's 2016. And we cried out today to awake the hearts of your people. Awake the hearts of those that need to be saved, God. Lord, today we are desperate for you. And yesterday we learned about three keys that is part of pre-revival. That's hope, inspiration, and expectation. And the last key that he opened the door is faith. And Lord, we are here today not just with hope, and with expectation, but today, Father, I pray that the inspiration come to our hearts to realize that we need revival now, that we need an awakening now in order to save those souls that today are dying without Christ. So, Father, today we rise up here right now in this moment to pray like Habakkuk. And to say, Lord, revive your church. Come on, I'm going to ask you to pray with me, please. Revive your work, Lord, today. Revive every marriage in this city. Revive your people, Lord. Revive the worship. Hey, revive the praise in this church. Revive, Father, the youth in this nation. Revive once again. The light light of Jesus Christ among the nation of Canada. Whoa, from north to south, from east to west. And just know, just revive up, and Father, make it known. Make it known so even in Vancouver, they can hear what God is doing here in London, Ontario. Now even in Newfoundland, they can hear what God is doing in London, in Jesus' mighty name. That even the GTA will know what God is doing here in this city, Lord. Here in this ministry. Father, revive your word. Come on, church, just pray for a moment with me. Revive your word, God. Revive your church. And not just this church, but revive every ministry in this city, Lord. Every ministry that glorifies Jesus. Every ministry that are moved by the Holy Spirit. Revive us, God. Release the rain today. Release the rain today, Lord. We join brothers and sisters worldwide to say, Lord, revive us. Revive us once again. We just don't want the bread for ourselves. We just don't want to worship here for ourselves. But we want, and we are the movement of God in the nation. We believe in the nation, Father. We are not just a ministry that is in a neighborhood. Yes, that's how we start. But God, we believe that we are a ministry called to touch not just the city, not just the province, but Father, we believe that we're called to touch the nation, the entire nation, God, with your gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. So, Father, start with us this morning. Start with us this morning. Revive us once again. Revive your work in my heart. Revive your work in my life. Revive your work in my mind, in my soul, in my spirit, even in my body, God. Revive this ministry. Revive the musicians in a higher level. Revive the choir in a higher level. Revive the ushers and the deacons in a higher, higher level, God. Whoa. Revive us. Revive us. This is the hour. And this is the season, God. We see the heavens cloud. We see the heavens that are clouds. And they are dark. Because they announce that rain is coming. So, Father, today we can sense by the Spirit, rain is coming in the Spirit. Rain is coming, and you will let it know. It will be a thunder. It will be a sound in the heavens that even, Father, those that don't believe will see it. Social media is ready. Everything is ready, God. Start crying out right now. Revive us this morning. Revive this service today. Revive this Spanish service. Revive our hearts. Come on, just pray for a moment. Oh, revive us. Revive my heart, God. Revive my heart as pastor. I don't know what your position is in the church. I don't know what your place is in the body of Christ. But you can say, Father, revive me right where I am right now. Allow me to be faithful in where I am. Because, Lord, I want to be faithful in the march. Whoa, revive us. Revive your work. In the midst of the day. And in the midst of the day, let it know, let it know, let it know, let it know. Come on, you can pray with me. And say, God, give us testimony. Extend your hand upon us. Yeah, is that even at work? Father, I'll be a testimony of Christ. In the college, I will be a testimony of Christ. In the high school, I will be a testimony of Christ. Holy Spirit, welcome today. Holy Spirit, welcome this morning. You are the invited. You are the honor. You are the honor guest in this house. You are the pastor. You are the leader. You are the father. Oh, you are the teacher. You are the master, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, come, 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 come today. Come today, come today, come today. Let's start worshiping. Oh, Jesus, glory to you today. Glory to you. Oh. Holy Spirit, and fill this house with your glory. Fill this house with worship and praise. Because in the middle of the worship, God moves. So Father, open our lips and let us be a river of your glory. Let us be a river of the manifestation of your Spirit today. Hallelujah.
How many are ready to praise the Lord? We're going to praise Him with all our heart, with all our mind. Amen? So I would like to everyone to stand up. We're going to worship Him with all our heart. Amen? Amen. So I would like to invite the worship team to come here. We're going to praise the Lord from the river. The back to come here to the front too. We're gonna praise Him from the river. Amen. Amen. Are you ready? I wanna see happy faces, because today is a happy day, even though outside is a little bit darker. And when you stand out this morning, when you woke up, it was like, oh my goodness, it's raining, it's not too much sun. We are blessed because we have one more day of life, and sometimes we do not appreciate that. We just open our eyes and we just say like, oh, it's another day. But no, it's a happy day because we are blessed. We have new life and we are healthy and we have our family and we don't need anything because the Lord is providing. Amen. Amen. Let you believe it or not. Amen. So we are free. Amen. We are free. Come on, clap.
See you.
to work, you go to work like this. Hi, boss. Ah. I don't think so. I don't think if the prime minister calls you to go to his house, you will go, yes, okay, what's that mean? I don't think so. I think that when you are worshiping the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, you have to do it with all of our heart, all your mind, with all your body. Do you understand that? I don't think so. Because I see him facing like this. And I don't think we praise the Lord like that. Angels are singing every day and night, 24 hours, with a smile saying, holy, holy, holy. And they don't get tired because they know that they are worshiping the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, the Majesty. So I think the babies are praising with more happiness than the people that is grown up. So we have to be like babies. Even though you didn't eat this morning breakfast, or maybe you didn't sleep well yesterday night, they don't care. You see? So I want you to think like that. Okay? So we're gonna praise him. Come on. 1, 2, 3, from the beginning.
I am free.
Come on, I am free to run.
I am free.
Our God is greater. are greater, that you are stronger, that you are higher, that you are our healer, that you are awesome, that you are God, you are great, and oh Lord, yes you are, yes Lord, you are great. Close your eyes and just talk to Him. This is a moment of praise. It's a moment of worship. You can praise Him. You can worship Him. Do whatever you want to do just for Him. That is in your heart, is the time to put it in the Lord's hands. Once the Lord, I'm worried about my college, I'm worried about my work or my job, I worry about my family, my children, my husband, my wife, I'm worried about my home, about my financial situation. Everything that is in your heart that is worrying you, put it in the Lord's hands. Your future, your career, your dreams. Many of you have dreams. So put your dreams in His hands. Are you praying for a vacation time, for holidays? Are you praying for a new home? Are you praying for a new car? Are you praying for something? Is the time to put in the Lord's hands. Are you praying for a new job? Are you praying for a new opportunity? Are you praying for doors be open? This is the time that you put it in the Lord's hands and say, Lord, everything that is worrying me, I put it in your heart, in your hands, oh Lord. So you do your will. You do your will, because in the Bible says that your will is perfect. Mine is not. Your will is perfect, oh Lord. And if it's your will, I will accept it because it's perfect. And I know that you are working on me and my family and my dreams, my desires, and everything that is around me. Why? Because you love me. You love me first. That any other one. You love me first. Come on, it's the time that you talk to him. It's the time that you are separated for him. People in here, they are having dreams that they are not bringing peace in your heart. There are no nightmares. There are dreams that they are putting your heart and your mind like knowing peace. That you had, is it time to say, Lord, please take that dream, and if it's something that is going to happen in the future, please tell me so, and if it's not, please take it from my mind. I don't want to be worried for that anymore. People in here are having trouble to get in sleep. Not because you are busy, it's not because you are tired, no, it's just because your mind is constantly thinking and thinking. Put all your thoughts in the Lord's hands. Come on, this is the time to put it. This is the time that you have. This is the chance that the Lord is giving you. Do it. Maybe you don't know if you're gonna have time later. Maybe you don't know if you're gonna do it tonight. Maybe you don't know that you're gonna do it tomorrow. This is the time. The Lord timing is perfect. So I believe this is the time to put everything in the Lord's hands. Lord timing is perfect. We as a Christians, we need to know where is the time, the perfect time from the Lord. And I believe this is the time. You are having trouble at your work. This is the time to put it in the Lord's hands. People are treating you badly. Maybe they are not being fair with you in your school and your work. Your neighbors, your family. Sometimes the closest friend or the closest family is the one that brings you sorrow. But believe me, it's not them. It's an influence of the evil that wants you to bring you down. But don't let that happen. It's this opportunity to put in the Lord's hands and say, Lord, I'm not going to be worried about my friends. I'm not going to be worried about my family, because you, Lord, you are taking care of it. You are in control. So you are doing it, oh Lord. You are doing it, Jesus. You are doing it, Holy Spirit. You are doing it. Come on. time for praying. This is time to say, oh Lord, please do it so. That needs prayer, and we're gonna take 5 minutes to pray for the people that needs prayer. I believe that, I feel that. We cannot go from song to song if it's sorrow in the house. From the spirit that is sorrow. There's no peace in here. People in here that have trouble in their minds, they are trying to do something but they can't. They don't feel joy. Sometimes it's not easy to smile. Missing somebody. Maybe you are fighting with somebody. And the Lord is asking us that before we go to His presence, we need to forgive. And I feel that today people is lacking in forgiveness. And I know by experience that forgive is one of the most harder things to do. But it's the most important thing that the Lord wants us to do, so He can flow in ourselves, inside of us. Also, there is people that is missing somebody. Maybe you are missing your family. Maybe you are missing your mom, your dad, your brother, your sister. Maybe you are missing one of your children. And you know, missing is good, but no, it's good when it brings sorrow and pain. So I want you to, if you want to come to the altar, we want to pray for you. And if you don't want to come to the altar, just raise your hand. I think we are not too many, and we can go and pray for you. Don't be afraid. In here we are not to judge you. In here we are just to support you, to encourage you, to love you because we are family and we can love each other and pray each other and bring comfort and encouragement. So don't be afraid. If you feel that you need to forgive somebody and it's getting harder and harder to do it, just come, we can pray for you that the Lord will bring you the peace to do it. The Bible says that the Holy Spirit will bring the desire to do it. If you are missing somebody, just come to the front too. We can pray for you because the love of each other will bring peace. It will bring the love that you're missing. If you are having trouble to concentrate in the Lord's presence, sometimes it's getting harder and harder to go into the presence of the Lord, and you need the fire, and you need His thirst. Come to the front, we can pray for you. Don't be afraid. Thank you.
I'm not afraid to die.
declare that forever, forever He is. Forever He will be glorified. Forever He will be with us. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, just take a moment wherever you are and just give thanks to the Lord. Tómate un momento donde quieras estés, dale gracias al Señor por lo que está haciendo. Give every thanks to the Lord for everything that He's doing right now. Sometimes we don't see it happening right now, but God is moving. Algunas veces no lo vemos moverse, pero Dios está moviendo. You can declare by faith, God. Maybe when somebody prayed for me, I didn't feel anything, but something that I know is that You move. You answer our prayers. Tal vez cuando oraron por mí no sentí nada, pero yo puedo declarar: mi Dios está moviéndose en mi favor y está tocando mi casa, está tocando mi vida. And He's touching my life and my family. And I believe, God. I believe because this is by faith. So I want to thank You right now, Lord. I want to thank You for every life that is ministered by Your Spirit today. Damos gracias por cada familia o cada persona que ha sido ministrada en esta casa, Señor, en este momento. Because it's not us, it's You, Holy Spirit. Porque no somos nosotros, Señor, es Tu Espíritu Santo. Le has dado palabra a las personas. Holy Spirit, You've been speaking to them. I want to thank You, Lord. We receive the peace that the world can give, but the peace of Jesus in our hearts. Hoy tomamos la paz que el mundo no puede dar, pero la paz de Jesús. Father, we prepare our hearts for the word. Preparamos nuestro corazón para la palabra que traes en esta mañana. And Father, we pray that You can touch our lives, our generations, today and forever. Y que puedas tocar nuestro corazón y nuestra vida y nuestros pensamientos. Give You thanks for the provision this week. Damos gracias por la provisión de esta semana. And if somebody has a burning for financials right now, y si alguien ahora mismo tiene una carga por parte financiera, Father, we declare provision will come. Declaramos que la provisión vendrá. So Father, we rest in You in the provision for our houses. Descansamos en Ti por la provisión de nuestros hogares. We don't have to be worried what we're gonna do next month. We don't have to be worried about what the job is. We know that You're gonna take care of us. No vamos a preocuparnos por el salario del próximo mes o por el trabajo que va a pasar, porque confiamos en Ti, Señor, de que Tú suplirás todas nuestras necesidades. So Señor, so Lord, we want to close this moment. Bringing our tithes and offerings to the altar. Queremos traer, cerrar este momento trayendo nuestros diezmos y ofrendas al altar. And on this anointing we want to do it. Y bajo esta unción queremos hacerlo con reverencia. So let's take a moment to bring tithes and offerings. But I want to ask you something. Please take some time in the offering box and just pray for a moment. Says, God, I trust You. And it's an offering in the altar because I know You will be my provider. You are my provider forever and ever. Así que le animo que esta mañana cuando venga aquí al altar pueda tomarse un tiempo allí en la canasta de la ofrenda y pueda declarar allí que Él es tu proveedor y que nada te faltará. Vamos a hacerlo con alegría esta mañana. bueno, you are so good, God. You're so great, Lord. Anointing is moving, just give it thanks. And we're gonna walk straight to the word of the Lord. La unción está moviéndose en este lugar, el Señor está ministrando tu corazón. Te puede decirle, Señor, prepara mi corazón para la palabra. Prepare my heart for the word that we're about to hear. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Gracias, Señor. Gracias. So let's pray together right now. Vamos a orar juntos ahora mismo. Say, Father, thank you for your grace and your mercy today. Vamos, gracias, dile gracias, Señor, por tu gracia y tu amor. Father, I pray you can bless the word that we're about to receive. We open our hearts, we open our ears and our understanding to hear your voice. Abrimos nuestro corazón y nuestro entendimiento para escuchar tu voz en esta preciosa mañana. Señor, ministranos y que esta palabra no sea una palabra religiosa, pero una palabra rema a nuestro corazón. Father, that this word won't be a religious word, but it will be a word rema in our hearts. Thank you, Lord. We give you mighty praise and glory and honor today. In Jesus' mighty name. En el nombre de Jesús damos la gloria, la alabanza, el honor. Y todos decimos amén y amén. Démosle un fuerte aplauso a Jesús. Give a mighty applause to Jesus today. Señor, gracias por lo que estás haciendo. Amén. You may be seated. Creo que los niños pueden salir, los bebés o los niños chiquitos pueden salir a la escuela. The kids actually, we're in English. Yes, the kids can go to school. Sometimes I don't even remember which one I am right now, but I'm going to ask you, good morning, thank you for being here. Wow, God is moving, God is touching our lives. Dios está moviendo, Dios está tocando nuestras vidas. And I want to ask you to open your Bibles right now. And in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 24 and 27, we're going to read through those verses this morning, and we're going to ask Holy Spirit to speak to our hearts. Vamos a abrir el libro de 1 Corintios, capítulo 9, versículo 24, 27. So I'm going to ask you, let's do it that way. English, because I don't know if you have any Spanish, but it's okay, you can leave it like that. I'll try to explain in Spanish a little bit about it. Okay, so the Bible says this, dice la Biblia lo siguiente, the Bible says this, do you know that those who run, say with me run, digo amigo correr, say with me run, with those who run in a race all run, but one, say with me one, only one receive the prize, solamente uno recibe el precio, it says this, run in such a way that you may obtain it. And everyone who competes for the prizes temper in all things. Now they do it to obtain a perishable crown, but we for an imperishable crown. Therefore, I run. Say with me, I run. Come on, say with me, I run. It means yo corro. Yeah, I run. Thus, not with uncertainty, thus I fight, not as someone who beat the air, but I discipline my body and bring it into subjection, lest when I have preached to others and myself should become what? Disqualified. Let me see if I can read it here in Spanish so you can a little bit understand what I'm saying. I'm talking in Spanish. You know, I'm mixing. Todo estoy hablando todo confundido en inglés y español. Pero dice la palabra en inglés español, dice, no sabes que los que corren en el estadio, todos a la verdad corren, pero uno se lleva el premio. Corre de tal manera que lo obtengáis. Todo aquel que lucha de todo se abstiene. Ellos a la verdad para recibir una corona corruptible, pero nosotros una incorruptible. Así que yo de esta manera corro, no como a la aventura, que de esta manera peleo, no como quien golpea al aire, sino que golpeo mi cuerpo y lo pongo en servidumbre, no sea que habiendo sido heraldo para otros, yo mismo venga a ser eliminado. So when I preach to others, I myself should become disqualified. And we all say amen and amen. And I want to teach about running. Say with me, running. Digo, me go corriendo. That's what I want to teach this morning. That's what the Holy Spirit is teaching us today in this class. And look at in this teaching today. Lo que el Espíritu nos está enseñando en esta preciosa mañana. Because the Apostle Paul is saying we have to run in this way of life. Y tenemos, el Apóstol Pablo está hablando de que tenemos que correr en esta carrera, ¿qué? De la vida. And we have to run. And it says this, the athletes, they run for a corruptible crown. So a crown that it doesn't have eternal value. Y dice el apóstol, los atletas corren por una medalla, por una corona que realmente no tiene valor eterno. But the apostle said, we have to run for a crown that is incorruptible, for a crown that is eternal. Say with me, eternal. Conmigo, eterno. El apóstol está diciendo, ustedes tienen que correr y tienen que esforzarse por una corona que va a ser eterna. Say with me, eternal. Digo conmigo, eterno. Because something that we have to understand is that the day we do that, you know, this week I went to the hospital. Esta semana yo fui a un hospital, and I did a visitation to someone that the first time I see them. Y cuando fue una visitación a unas personas que es la primera vez que las veo, and she's dying. And she's, I don't know, she's probably 50, maybe, I don't know if she's 60, maybe 58, 59, maybe 60, but she's dying and she's in the bed. Y visita a persona que tiene una persona que está en el hospital y tiene como 58, 59 años, casi 60 tal vez, y está muriendo. And you know what, when I went over there, And I saw her in the bed, you know, God moved my heart. God moved my heart because she is just waiting to die. She's like sitting there, says, you know, I'm just here waiting, and I'm just waiting for God to take me home. Ella decía, solamente me está diciendo, yo estoy aquí en la cama postrada, no me puedo mover, y simplemente estoy esperando que el Señor me llame. So she said that the whole family have everything arranged for the funeral, and I mean everything is ready. Everything is ready, the funeral is ready, the place is ready, and I was todo estaba listo ya. Ella me dice, todo está listo el funeral, los hijos ya tienen listo, me imagino que tienen ya listo la stone, ya tienen el spot. I mean, everything is ready. They are just waiting for her to die. And I was like, oh God, and with my wife and my pastor Diana and myself, we went over there and we pray and we believe that God can heal her. Amen. Y nosotros creímos que Dios puede sanarla. Amen. But something that makes me think is how we're going to finish the race in our lives. Y lo que me hace pensar es cómo vamos a terminar nuestra carrera de la vida, nuestra carrera. Because one day we're going to die. Yes, it's something that we cannot hide from. It's something that is real. One day we're going to die. We don't know when. It could be one. It could be tomorrow. It could be one next week. It could be 1 year, 2 years, 10 years, 20 years. 50 years ahead. I don't know when, but something that we have to know is that we have to end this race really good. Y algo que tenemos que tener es que podemos morir mañana, en una semana, en un mes, dos meses. Ella está esperando morirse. Realmente tocó mi corazón. Pero lo que me hace pensar, señores, ¿cómo vamos a terminar nuestra carrera? How we're going to end the race that we are racing today? How we're going to end this race? How we're going to present ourselves before the Lord? ¿Y cómo nos vamos a presentar delante del Señor? Because something that we know is that this body will die. Amen. Este cuerpo va a morir, ¿cierto que sí? But something that we understand also is that our spirit will be our soul, and our spirit. Our spirit is coming back to God. But our soul will be before the Lord, and I don't know what God is going to tell us. But something that I see in Apostle Paul saying here is that we have to run with all our hearts in order to reach the potential here on earth and be success in heaven. Amen. Es lo que el apóstol está diciendo, es que tenemos que correr en la vida, tenemos que correr bajo la bendición del Señor y trabajar y creer para que al final de la carrera podamos recibir qué, la corona. Dice la palabra, la corona de qué. De la vida, the crown of life. It's something that we have to understand. Look what it says in Luke chapter 16, verse 16. Mira lo que dice el libro de Lucas, capítulo 16 y versículo 16. Say with me, run. Digo conmigo, correr. I believe we have to run with all our hearts in our faith with Jesus Christ. Yes, look what it says right there. The law and the prophet were until John. Since that time, the kingdom of God has been preached, and everyone is what? Pressing into it. La ley y los profetas, que dice ahí, eran hasta Juan, y desde entonces el reino de Dios, que dice ahí, es anunciado, y todos, digo amigo todos, say with me, everybody, digo amigo todos. What is it? Everybody's lazy. No. Todo el mundo se queda, está cansado, perezoso. No. ¿Qué dice? Y todos, ¿qué dice ahí? Se esfuerzan por entrar en él. Because it says this in English. It says, and everyone is pressing into it. So something that Apostle Paul knows is that he's an apostle, but he have to run with all his heart in order to finish the race of life. And receive the good words from the Lord. Y algo que el apóstol Pablo decía, yo soy apóstol, soy predico la palabra, pero yo corro porque al final no quiero venir a ser qué? Eliminado. Because he said, I want to run with all my heart because I don't want to be what? Eliminated. You know, in 1992 in the Olympics games, en 1992 en los Juegos Olímpicos, there was a man called Derek Redmond. Había un hombre llamado Derek Redmond en los Olímpicos de 1992 en Barcelona. And you know what? He was the one that broke the record on 400 meters sprint, it's called, I think. Right. Él fue que rompió el récord de 400 metros planos. And he was in the semifinals in the Olympics. Él estaba en las semifinales en los Olímpicos. And when the race started, he started like a bullet. ¿Eh? Él comenzó la carrera como una bala, you know, really fast. And he was going like, whoo, everybody said he's going to win. Because he was looking for a gold medal. Estaba detrás de una medalla de qué? De oro. And he started with all his heart in the race. But in the middle of the race, he had a problem in his leg. And you can see him like, whoo, like that. And en medio de la carrera le dio un problema en la pierna, un estirón. Y realmente quedó ahí. Everybody, you know, finished the race. And I don't know if you just have seen that video, but his dad came. Y no sé si usted vio ese video, pero su padre vino. In the middle of the race, in the Olympic Games, his dad was the coach. Su padre era el entrenador. Y en medio de los Olímpicos, his dad grabbed him and he started walking like this. And the dad came to Derek. Y el papá vino already. Y le dijo, Derek, your leg is hurt. Let's go. I mean, you couldn't finish. Let's go, Derek. You know, let's go home. Y el papá le decía, Derek, tu pierna se lastimó. No puedes terminar la carrera. Vámonos. Y él decía, no. You can see the video. He's like, no, daddy, I want to finish the race. And then he grabbed his dad and started walking like that. And the whole stadium just stood up and started clapping, and he finished the race with one leg like this. How you say this? Cojeando, ¿cómo se dice? Cojeación. Sí. Y él termina la carrera abrazado de su padre, cojeando. ¿Cómo se dice cojear en inglés? ¿Cómo? Crippling? Limping? Something like that. You got the idea, right? But why I'm talking about Derek? ¿Por qué estoy hablando acerca de Derek? Because he finished the race. Maybe he was, you know, like a little bit this, but he did it. And you know what? There's many Christians that they will never end the race. There's many people that it will be eliminated on the way home. Because something that you have to understand is heaven is home. Say with me, heaven is home. Digo amigo, el cielo es nuestro hogar. Come on, say with me, el cielo es nuestro hogar. Because we need to understand something. Earth is just a time of a residence. ¿Eh? La tierra solamente es un tiempo de qué? De residencia. That's it. But our citizenship, the Bible says, is where? In the heavens. Say with me, in the heavens. Dios mío, mi ciudadanía está en los cielos. So we have to end this race, and we have to do it. We have to go to heaven. You know, I'm really sad to hear those people that he says, oh, my dad died and my mom died, and I'm gonna see them in heaven, and they don't even know Christ. How are you gonna see somebody if they don't know Christ? Well, the bad news is if you don't believe in Christ, you're not going to heaven. So there's no hope. That's why Jesus Christ is our hope. Pero es que la gente me da tristeza con las personas que dicen, oh, se murió la tía, se murió el tío, oh, lo veremos a ellos. Salúdenme Natal, salúdenme. Y they never met Christ, y nunca conocieron a Cristo. Porque la Biblia dice, the only way to the Father is to Jesus Christ. Y que el único camino al Padre, ¿quién es? Yes, and we have to run and we have to make sure we get there. Say with me, we get there. Come on, do you know the race? Do you know the end of the race is not here on earth? The end of the race is where? Is where? In heaven. Say with me, el final de la carrera no es en la tierra. El final de la carrera no es la universidad. El final de la carrera no es el trabajo, casa, beca y carro. El final de nuestra vida es donde? En los cielos. That's why Jesus is saying here, it says here, everyone is pressing into it. Y todos tienen que, ¿qué? Esforzarse para entrar, ¿dónde? En él. Jesus said, the door that is the door that it leads to destruction is a wide open door. But the door that it leads to salvation is a narrow door. En la Biblia dice, Jesús dijo algo, la puerta que lleva a la perdición es una puerta, ¿qué? Ancha. Pero la puerta que lleva a la salvación es una puerta, ¿qué? Angosta. And today I'm speaking about run, run. Say with me, run, run. So correr, correr. En el libro de Romanos 4:18, en el libro de Romans 4:18, there was a man that he ran, and he ran for almost 14 years. He was 100 something because he reached the gold medal. And his name was Abraham. And look what happened to Abraham. Un hombre que llegó a la meta y que llegó con los brazos arriba. ¿Quién fue? Abraham. Abraham corrió y siguió y obedeció al Señor hasta el final de sus días. Y dice la palabra, says this, who contrary to hope and hope believe, so that they become the father of many nations, according to the word spoken, so shall the descendants will be. It says, y creyó, ¿qué dice ahí? En esperanza contra esperanza, para llegar a ser, ¿qué dice ahí? Padre de mucha gente, conforme a lo que se le había dicho, así será tu descendencia. So it was hope against hope. And that's something that we spoke on Tuesday on prayer. Algo que hablamos el martes, ¿qué esperanza contra quién? Contra esperanza. Yeah, the enemy wants to hold you back, and the plan of the enemy is to stop you in order to reach your gold medal. The enemy that wants to steal your gold medal in heaven. He said, you know what? God, Satan cannot destroy God. You know that? But Satan can lead us into destruction. And we have to take care of it, and we have to understand that, and we have to make sure we are running with fire in our hearts straight to heaven. Lo que tenemos que entender es que Satanás no puede destruir a Dios, pero Satanás sí puede destruir la creación y el propósito de Dios en la tierra. Si le permitimos, if we allow him, that's what we need to run. Pues porque tenemos que, ¿qué? Que correr con qué? Como with this, with hope. Say with me, hope. Say with me, hope. Diego, mi esperanza. Yes, he did it. He waited, he had hope, and he finished the race. He had his son, the promise of God in his life. Y él corrió la carrera de la vida y recibió, ¿qué? La promesa de quién? De Dios. En Book of Hebrews, and I finish with this, en el libro de Hebreos, capítulo 6, termino con esto, en el versículo 11, it says this, and we desire that each one of you show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope until the end. Until the what? The end. Hebrews, please. That you do not become sluggish, but imitate those who through faith and patience inherit the promises. Hebreos, a fin de que no, ¿qué dice ahí? Hagas perezosos, sino imitadores de aquellos que por la fe y la paciencia heredan. ¿Me puedes colocar el verso 11? Can you put 11? Because I know you put 12, but 11. But dice, pero deseamos que cada uno, ¿qué dice ahí? ¿Hasta cuándo? ¿Hasta cuándo? Hasta el fin. Say with me, to the end. Say with me, to the end. So Jesus promised something. I will be with you until what? The end. So something that we have to understand, and we cannot blame God. Because Jesus promised he's going to be with us until the end. No podemos de echar la culpa al Señor, porque Jesús prometió que estará con nosotros hasta cuándo? Hasta el final. So we are the ones that need to run. We are the ones that need to believe. We are the ones that need to pray. We are the ones to have to worship. We are the ones who make sure we go to the end. And one day God is going to call us. Y Dios un día nos va a llamar a su presencia, but we can finish like this. Woo! So when pastor died, don't cry. I've been telling that my wife about that. Se le a mi esposa Lucía, cuando el pastor se muera no van a llorar. Nobody can cry. We're going to celebrate. Woo! Pastor finished the race. Yes. ¿El pastor qué? Terminó la carrera. Wait, one day we're going to die. I don't know my wife first or me first, but we're going to celebrate. Because we're going to heaven. Amen. Vamos a celebrar cuando nos muramos vos. ¿Por qué los cristianos? You know, people say, Christians are crazy. People are dying and they celebrate. They sing. They worship. It's a time for crying and mourning. ¿Cómo se dice? Mourning? Sorrow. It's not. It's not, because when we die, we're going to heaven. If you did the right thing, if you believe in Christ, and if you run with all your heart, you need to know that you're going straight to heaven. Amen. And the first thing that God is going to do is just say, welcome. Well done. You end the race. He's the crown of what? Of eternal life. Y cuando lleguemos al final de la carrera, cuando el Señor nos llama a su presencia, listen, one day, there's people that he die and don't even notice when. There's people that he die don't even suffer, just like, boop. And when they wake up, like, whoo, where I am. You know, they probably didn't finish the race. They probably got eliminated on the way. Personas que se mueren de un momento para otro, ni se dieron cuenta, ni se durmieron ni se despertaron. Pero al otro lado, but on the other side, say with me, the other side, en el otro lado, God is waiting. If you believe in Christ, God is waiting for you. Oh, if you don't believe in Christ too, because you're going to go to be judged anyway. So. Si usted no cree en Cristo, si la persona no cree en Cristo, va a ser judged anyway, va a ser juzgada por el poder de Dios. So something that we have to understand today, algo que tenemos que entender, and something that I want to speak and leave very clear today, is that we have to be diligent. Algo que tenemos que entender esta mañana, que tenemos que ser, ¿qué? Diligentes. Until what? Until what? Just Sundays. Just half year. Just a few years, you know. Will I have, you know, enough to say I'm Christian and that's it, I don't do anything else? No. The Apostle Paul said, I have to run diligent. It means every day. Say with me, every day. Christians need to be Christian every day until the end of what? Until Jesus calls us. Actually, we pastors, we will never retire. We have to work until Jesus returns or calls us home. But we have to be diligent. And that's what I want to say today. We have to be diligent. ¿Tenemos que ser qué? Diligentes. Say with me, Diego, amigo, diligentes. Y quiero leer una vez más. En el 1 Corintios, Christian 9:24-27. Do you know that those who run in a race all run, but one receive the prize? Run. And that's what I want to say right there. Run. 1 Corinthians 9:24. Run in such a way that you may obtain it. ¿No sabéis que los que corren en el estadio todos a la verdad corren, pero uno solo se lleva el premio? Dice, correr de tal manera, ¿qué dice ahí? Que lo obtenga. Es tiempo de correr. It's time to run. Say with me, run with all our hearts. Danny, can you come? Can you stand up? ¿Puede ponerse de pie conmigo? I'm not saying you're going to die soon, okay? I want you to be clear on that. Yo quiero dejarle claro algo. No estoy diciendo que usted va a morirse prontamente. No, it's not. That's not what God wants. But something, there's something that people saying. It says we have to be prepared. Be prepared like you're going to live 100 years. But be prepared or you're going to die tomorrow. Un dicho que dice, prepárese como si fuera a vivir 100 años, pero también prepárese como si fuera a vivir solo un día. If God calls us to his presence tomorrow or this afternoon, will you receive the crown? Will you receive the gold medal? Si el Señor nos llamara hoy mismo a su presencia, o mañana, ¿llevaríamos la corona de la vida? Would you hear the voice of the Lord saying, well done? ¿Escucharía usted la voz del Señor diciéndole, bien hecho? The Apostle Paul says that I have to run because I don't want to be those that he preached the gospel and at the end what? Be eliminated. El apóstol decía, yo no quiero ser aquellos que predican el evangelio y al final cuando lleguen a la corte del Señor, ¿sega qué? Eliminado. Something that reminds me this is the movie, you know the movie. Remember the movie I was talking about the movie? Left Behind. La movie, la película, ¿cómo se dice en español esa película? Dejado atrás, creo que se llama, algo así traduce. The thing is dejado atrás. Sounds weird, but it's better in English. Left Behind. Because in that movie, Christ comes and the church is taken away. Porque en esa película todos son llevados. El rapto, ocurre el rapto, ¿cierto que sí? Todos son llevados. And the pastor is the one that stays. Y el pastor es el que se queda. Oh. Tell the one beside you, we cannot be eliminated. Dile que está al lado tuyo, no podemos ser eliminados. Oh, no. I know it's good to hear that God wants to bless us. Yo sé que es bueno escuchar que Dios nos quiere bendecir. But it's also good to know that we have to be ready to be God to heaven. Es algo también, es bueno que escuchar que Dios nos quiere bendecir, prosperar. Pero también es bueno saber que Dios está esperando que estemos, ¿qué? Preparados para ir, ¿cómo? Al cielo. You know, this lady in the hospital said, I'm ready to go. She said that. Esta mujer en el hospital dijo, ahí postrada en la cama, dijo, estoy lista para ir. Y la pastora le dijo, are you sure? La pastora le preguntó, ¿está lista? Y yo dijo, yes. The pastor Diana felt that she needed to do a prayer, asking Jesus for mercy for her soul. Y la pastora escuchó la voz del Señor que le dijo, ella tiene que hacer la oración de fe, declarando que su esperanza está en Jesús. So right there in bed we pray. Pastor Diana lead her in prayer. Y ahí la pastora en la cama la llevó al Señor. And I don't know if God will despair her life or not. Something that I know is that we are gonna see her in heaven. And she's gonna see God maybe tomorrow. I don't know when God's gonna take her. But it made me think, are we ready? Y si no sé cuándo Dios se la va a llevar, solamente es una cosa, la vamos a ver en el cielo. Porque ella puso su fe en el Señor. We have to run with all our hearts. Be faithful to God. Be obey the word. Believe in Holy Spirit. Do God's will. Then we're going to say, I'm ready, God. You know, I'm going to live my life I'm going to live 100. But if you call me tomorrow, I'm ready. Señor, voy a preparar mi vida como si fuera a vivir, ¿qué? 100 años. Pero si me llamas mañana, I'm ready. Because I know that I run with all my heart in this calling of Jesus. Porque voy a poder decir, Señor, he corrido la carrera que me ha llamado Jesús a correr. So today I'm going to encourage you to run. Tell the one beside you, run with all your heart. Because I want to see you in heaven. Vamos a decir, está al lado tuyo. Tienes que correr con todo el corazón. Porque te queremos ver en el cielo. Amén. Amén. How many of you are you gonna take in the challenge to run even faster? You have to run even faster. So get in shape. Spiritual speaking, you know. Así que prepárese, póngase en forma espiritualmente hablando. Yeah, because you know, if you go to heaven and you see somebody from the church, you know, like in another level, you say, I used to go to church with that person. Because you know, then the heavens are levels, eh? En el cielo hay niveles. You know, there's people that are going to be close to Jesus. There's people that are going to just barely, you know, close the door like, woo, I just made it. Woo. And it's good. I mean, I'm not saying it's bad. Yo sé que hay gente que va a estar cerca al Señor, hay gente que está más lejos, hay unos que apenas van a entrar, como dicen en mi país, por promedio. They're gonna cross the line just by average. But God is asking us today to run. To run for our families, to run for our children, to run for our generation in the glory of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Come on, raise your hands for a moment. Levanta su mano por un momento. And say, Lord Jesus, help me to run this race of faith with fire and passion in my heart. Señor, ayúdame a correr, Señor, esta carrera de la fe con pasión, con esfuerzo y con diligencia. Father, we don't want to be eliminated. We don't want to be at the end of the line. But we want to be in your glory, Lord. And we know that this is defined by what we do right now. Señor, ayúdanos a correr con todo el corazón. No queremos estar lejos de ti. Queremos estar tan cerca como sea posible. Y sabemos que eso se define o se determina aquí en la tierra. Señor, si el apóstol Pablo, if the apostle Paul said that he would be eliminated, and he wrote 13 letters in the Bible, and he led I don't know how many people to Christ. Whoa, we have to be ready. We have to work really hard. Señor, si el apóstol Pablo escribió que él podía ser eliminado después de haber escrito 13 cartas, después de haber salvado no sé cuánta gente, llevando a gente al cristianismo, ¿cuánto más nosotros podemos ser eliminados? So, Father, in Jesus' mighty name, I pray that you can give us the fire to run this race of faith in the gospel of Jesus Christ until the end of the days. Ayúdanos, Señor, a tener la fuerza y la pasión para correr esta carrera de la vida con fuego y con pasión. So the day you call us, we're gonna be there in your glory, smiling. Para que el día que nos llames a tu presencia, podemos estar allí, Señor, sonriendo. Podemos estar allí alabándote y podemos escuchar la voz diciéndote, bien, buen siervo fiel. So we can hear your voice saying, good, faithful servant, welcome to your house. Welcome home. Que nos pueda decir bienvenido a casa. I don't know in which area of your life you're falling. No sé qué parte de tu vida estás tropezando. I don't know in which area of your life you maybe are running backwards. No sé en qué área de tu vida estás corriendo, o tal vez en contravía. But something that you have to know is that God is waiting for you to run this race of faith with all your heart. Algo que Dios está esperando de ti es que corras la carrera hacia adelante y con todo tu corazón. That's what God's saying. You have to love your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your spirit. God wants us to run this race with everything that we have. Por eso dice el primer mandamiento, amarás a Dios con todo tu corazón, con todas tus fuerzas, con toda tu mente. Significa Dios quiere que corra esta carrera con todo lo que tú tienes. Today is a day of determination. Hoy es un día de determinación. De decir, Señor, voy a correr esta carrera, estos años que tengo por delante, Señor, con todo el corazón, para obedecerte, para escuchar tu voz, para adorarte, para servirte, para prepararme, Señor, para ese día glorioso que me llamas a tu presencia. Lord, I'm gonna run this race, worshiping, praying, seeking the Lord, being ready for that marvelous day that you're gonna come. So, Father, we wanna thank you for your word. Tenemos gracias por tu palabra that encourages us today, que nos levanta y nos anima hoy to keep believing and to be diligent every day in our lives. Para que nos anima y nos levanta a ser diligentes en el llamado del cristianismo, in the calling of the Christianity that we have in our lives. Because I'm Christian, not just because I'm coming to a Christian church, I'm Christian because Christ lives in me. Y yo soy cristiano no porque vengo a la iglesia cristiana, pero porque Jesús vive en mi corazón. So today, Holy Spirit, come. So Espíritu Santo, ven esta mañana sobre mi vida. Vamos, dile, ayúdame, Espíritu Santo. Vamos, Él es el ayudador de nuestra vida. Él nos va a ayudar a correr con pasión. Come on, he's the one who's going to help us to run with fire and passion in our lives. So Holy Spirit, help us. Help us, help us, help us to be in shape. Help us to run with everything. In Jesus' mighty name, Lord, help us to lead our family into this marvelous glory of the heavens. Y ayúdanos aún a liderar y llevar a nuestras familias a esta maravillosa gloria llamada los cielos. Te damos gracias, Señor. Declaramos que un día te veremos. Father, we declare that one day we will see you. And a smile will be on your face. And joy will come to our hearts. Y un día te veremos, Señor, y habrá alegría y gozo en tu rostro. Father, we're leaving this place, but never ever your glory, your presence. Vamos a este lugar, pero jamás tu presencia. No vamos en victoria. We leave this place in victory, declaring, yes, I'm going to be in heaven, and I'm going to end the race in fire and passion for Jesus. Declaramos que vamos a terminar la carrera en alegría, en gozo y en fuego, ardiendo por pasión por Jesús. Te lo damos gracias, Señor, en el nombre de Jesús. Y todos decimos esta mañana, amén. And we say all this morning, amen. Amen, amen. Give a mighty applause to the Lord. Woo! Vamos, dile que está al lado tuyo. Hay que correr con todo el corazón. Tell the one beside you, you have to run with all your hearts. Dios les bendiga. Lord bless you. Have a wonderful, wonderful afternoon. Dios les bendiga. Tenga un feliz, feliz día. Una feliz tarde a todos. Woo! Okay, that's it. The run is over.